There are times I find myself drawn to him. Or he draws me in his dreams, his lonely sleep. Times when I'm pulled and called by a past so lost I can no longer invent it. But drawn to what? Maybe a beginning, maybe. That's what draws me back to him on occasion, wanting. Wanting what? Wanting him? No. Wanting to remember. We were innocent then, wandering a newly risen world, its seedlings and its sproutings, its empty waters and its warm sun, everything reaching for a young sun. He and I and him, one being really, one being in two bodies rolling together in the sweet and the simple mud, rain and sun and light and dark, following circles. Before, before the words and shapes and endless dividing of things. Before the logic of fragmenting and naming and then breaking again. And again and again, each piece smaller and harder and denser and slower and colder. Always colder. You see, I grew enraptured by the ferocity of the world, her vast generosity, her dangerous spiral mysteries. Stars reflected in black tide pools and vines that curled eager tendrils around the curious finger, hyacinth and hyenas calling across the night. But Adam wanted to pound the world into his own measure, to control the uncontrollable and to shape things. I was his first attempt. So I grew wings, and the more that he tried to seize me, the farther I flew into azure skies, elemental passions, deep black waters, empty deserts, boneyards, and jungles. The more I hungered for the moon. But he demanded his way or no way. And when tantrums failed, he made for himself a womanless and jealous god, a god who would have no other. In all the vast garden of life, no other. So I rose, and I flew. Not for any price, not for Eden or bread or any ease, would I be anything less than what I am. Breast and bone and blood. So I left, and I found another lover. Samael, his hot wings and his volcanic heart, his sweet and his terrible kisses. Samael comprehends neither sin nor virtue, only the splendor of the ever-changing moment. What soarings we had. What flights. What progeny. And ribless Adam, with his poor, frightened, and innocent wife, his humble Eve of a new era. Adam, with his self-imposed shame and his rules and his words and his God, who made of me a demon. Well, I still remember sometimes when the whim or some winding sirocco wind takes me. Sometimes I kiss his sleeping lips when he calls for me in his dreams, in his silence, in his need.